currently headed out towards the photo location now. It's our local, one of our local petrol stations. My town does have a habit of building two of everything, so at least, so there's two pharmacies, there's three pubs, there's two servos, there's two supermarkets, sort of a lot of everything. So I'm heading out towards our service station that's got our car wash connected to it. I tried to take this photo about a year ago during lockdown. I had a particular image of how I wanted this to turn out in my head, but unfortunately it didn't come out quite as planned. There's a couple of difficulties that I'll run through once we get to the spot, but it was a dry night and I really, really wanted the reflections in it to be wet. But it's a wet night tonight. While I was at work, I looked out the windows and I saw the rain coming down and went, this could be the night. And then it stopped. So this could be the night. I'm actually really excited. So let's see how this goes. So in terms of gear for this shot, I'm gonna take it on two cameras. So I've got a Canon R6. And I've got a Canon 16 Mark II. The 16 Mark II has a bit more resolution. Not much, it's only 4 more megapixels. So, gonna give it a try on that. As I said, I'm gonna give it a try on my 16 Mark II just because it's got a bit more resolution. And this is a photo that I think could be very interesting if I printed it. But we'll see what happens. And we're taking on my R6 as well. Technique, gonna be using two, so I'm gonna do a straight wide angle shot. So we're using this 15 to 30 mil lens, probably sitting at around 15 to 20 mil depending on how wide I need it to be. The other technique will be a multiple photo HDR stack using my 70-200, probably at around 200, but hopefully the rain holds out for the rest of the shoot. Forecast says that it could rain in the next hour, but it also said that it could rain this hour and it hasn't, so not really trusting it too much tonight. We'll see how this goes. Just arriving at location now. So this is a Caltex petrol station, but as you can see just here. So it's actually a pretty cool looking petrol station, but this is what I'm interested in. It doesn't look like a lot. The video doesn't really get to show a lot because of the dynamic range. This is a massive dynamic range shot because of that. So above the car wash, there's a sign. It's got dog and car wash, and there's a bit of advertising up there for a company. That's way in the dark. There's no lights up there to brighten it up. And the lights all in the car wash are super, super bright, and there's white tiles and everything. So it's really difficult on cameras, as I found out last time. Fingers crossed we can pull it off. R6 might do really well because of the extended dynamic range and the really good high ISO performance. Last time I shot it on my 16 Mark II, so we'll have to see how that goes. So first things first, we'll do the 16 Mark II with the 70-200 first, and we'll might as well get the stack out of the way on that camera. The other hard thing about this is even though it's what about currently 10:45 at night, there's a surprising amount of traffic, especially four-wheel drives with really bright headlights that'll throw light on this scene, and it'll throw the sign into brightness, but it'll also throw extra light into the washing bays, which will massively overexpose them. So the shoot could be really challenging as well because of that. But let's get this started. I realise I should have brought two tripods so I can film myself setting up on one camera, but I've only got my Gorilla Pod with me, my tripod sitting in my car, so we'll get started. So here we go, 16 Mark II, battery grip, just because I'm going to shoot some Astro in the next couple of days, so I thought I'd throw it on. 70-200 from Tamron. Starting to rain a little bit, so I'm getting a little bit worried, but look, cameras are pretty well weather sealed, so we'll see how this goes. So perks of coming out here and not being overly prepared for this, I don't have a tripod plate on my 6D. So I can't use it because the only tripod plate I have with me is on the R6, and I need an Allen key, I think it is, to get it off. So I'll chuck this 15-30 on my 6D Mark II, move the mic over, and we'll shoot on the 6D Mark II instead. If this works, then I might have to come out another night and shoot with the 6D Mark II, but look, R6 will be fine. 20 megapixels is plenty, especially if I'm doing the HDR stack, so we'll be all good. No dramas. So we're on the 6D Mark II now. The 7200 is now on that R6 down there. So it's a huge, big, long lens on a very small camera. This isn't exactly how I wanted it to go. The tripod plate's on the camera rather than the lens. So there's gonna be quite a lot of weight on the lens mount and on the adapter, which I'm not super keen on, but I might even try the shot handheld to start with, just so I don't have to put all that weight on a GorillaPod on a camera body rather than the lens. So we'll see how this goes. Got the R6 in my hands here, 7200 Tamron f2.8. Love this lens to bits, it's beautiful. Fingers crossed we can get the shot done with just on handheld. I have no doubts on it. This camera is incredible in low light. I have some issues a little bit at like ISO 200 with noise, but if I crank this thing up to like 8000, it's clean. A little bit weird, still learning to get the quirks of it, but we'll see how it goes with this petrol station. Still really, really excited for this shot. Let's see how this goes. It's actually really hard on the 7200. It's harder than I remember. I think I did it on a 24-70 last time and just raked it out to 70. But doing it this way should give me some more resolution. I'm just not sure how the stack's gonna go. I'm not sure if it's actually gonna be able to stack. Just looking through the photos now, and I should have enough overlapping data on them. I've had to take something like 180 odd photos to try and do it all. I'm gonna have to play around with it quite a lot in Lightroom, and potentially even Photoshop. That might do a better stack of it. But we'll see how this goes. Should be interesting. So I've just taken a couple of still photos on my 6D Mark II. Using the 15-30 Tamron f2.8 as well, same as my 7200. The HDR seems like it could stack really well. The dynamic range on it should be good. I did it at 6400 ISO, which surprisingly is pretty clean on this. I know a lot of people say that it's a really noisy sensor, but I've honestly never really had issues with it. Shot Astro, shot nighttime stuff like this, shot nighttime street stuff, and noise has only been a major factor in a handful of times where I haven't been able to use a certain image. I'm gonna throw this lens onto my R6, and we'll see how that goes. I'm gonna have to call this shoot short. Started to rain and it's only seemingly gonna get heavier. So haven't managed to take any shots on the 15-30 on my R6. Might quickly snap a few as I chuck this in my bag and run into some cover, but we'll see. So I'm on my way home from the shoot now. Just like to take a couple of seconds to just thank you guys for watching, and if you'd like to see more, let me know, comment down below, subscribe. This is my first vlog. Been wanting to start a YouTube channel for a couple of years now after watching, you know, Peter McKinnon and Matty Hapoya, North Borders, Seventh Era, all those guys. Thought I could add some of my personality to the ring. tell you a bit about myself. So I live in a small country town in rural Victoria, just near Mount Buller. I am mainly a photographer, trying to get into video just to do some vlogs, some fun stuff like that. I shoot all Canon bodies, I shoot all Tamron lenses. So it's current time, I'm vlogging on an R6. I also shoot on a 6D Mark II, but my main camera since getting it is the Canon R6. I love it. I think it's phenomenal. The autofocus on it is something else. Yeah, it's just abilities are beyond anything I thought I would ever own. My main passion in photography is street photography and astrophotography. I have a wedding and engagement and family photography business on the side. I love shooting those events. There's nothing quite like catching certain looks or certain moments in things like an engagement or a wedding day. So when I get home, I'll dump all these files onto my laptop, and we'll see how it all adds together. Let's do it. All right, so update on this fuel station photo. Failed, so we're giving it another shot tonight. I've brought my proper tripod, so we'll chuck the 7200 on the R6. We'll do this properly. I'll post a photo just up there of what it turned out like. I didn't quite have enough photos for the stack, so didn't really work properly, but we'll see how this goes. Alright, so this is the setup. We've got the Canon R6 with the 7200 from Tamron sitting on the end of the body there. So I'm going to take probably three images of each part. So I just do a traditional HDR stack, and I'm going to do a bunch of photos from the top, then like the top quarter, and the bottom quarter, and then the very bottom. And then we're gonna stitch them all together in Lightroom, and we'll see how that goes. Last time I didn't quite take enough photos either side, so fingers crossed this time I don't make that mistake, and this shot can be finally done and dusted forever. Alrighty, so photos are all done now. About 276 photos later. This is gonna take a long ass time to stack in Lightroom. Not gonna be fun at all, but it is what it is, I guess. Let's get back home and see how this goes. All right, so come out to out near Howcliffe this morning to run you through how everything went for last night. So we ended up stacking 276 photos together. It worked. So here's the photo. So here's the raw. This is after the stack, obviously. I did a lot in post. I spent a lot of time in Lightroom, so I got home at about 11:30-ish, and then I didn't get to sleep until about 1:30. I normally don't spend anywhere near that long editing a single photo. Granted, a lot of that was the merge time, but yeah, I really, really wanted this to come out exactly how I wanted it to. I've spent a year dreaming about this photo, and I'm really glad that I can finally stop thinking about it, and I can get on with other projects. After all that, I'd like to say a massive thank you for watching. If you'd like to see more, let me know down in the comments. Make sure you hit that like button. It'd be amazing if you hit a subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.